Hi everyone, I welcome you to Astro Science. So today I have brought the planet Sun as I have promised. And since planet Sun is also known as Surya Graha, and if you have not watched my previous video, that defines the discrimination between the Graha and a planet, then you can go through my playlist on my channel and you will get the video which defines what a Graha and what a planet is and what do you mean by planet in astrology. So today is Sunday and I have brought the planet Sun, that is Surya Graha, for all of you. So let us start. Sun is the king of the solar system. That means all the planets revolve around the Sun. It is the main controlling unit, main controlling center which controls all the planets. That is the reason all planets revolve or spin around the Sun. In a basic sense, Sun gives us light and energy. As I am standing here and Sun is rising in the east and Kritika Nakshatra is working today. It is also the nakshatra which is associated with Sun. So as I am saying, that Sun is something which gives us, the Sun is that supreme power, that energy which gives us the light and energy in our life. Without the existence of Sun, there would have been no solar system. It awakens the thrust within us to learn, to gain the spiritual knowledge, the divine blessings, the eternal blessings. It takes away the darkness from our life. It brings light, it brings positivity in our life. That means it has healing qualities. That is the reason Sun can be called as a cosmic healer. Sun is a hot and bright planet. It has a kingly nature, that's royal splendor. That is the reason it also rules the fifth house of the natural zodiac, that is Leo. Now Leo is the lion. When you talk about lion, something comes in our mind, the king of the jungle. That means it controls over all the animals and birds in the jungle, and same does the Sun. Sun rules over all the planets of the solar system. All the planets revolve around the Sun. It is the Sun which is sitting in the center. It is situated, it is disposed in the center. And because of that kingly nature, Sun bestows a higher authoritative position. Means whenever Sun is disposed in the zodiac of a native in a very well dignified position, then that particular native will attain a higher position in life, a authoritative position in life. Now authoritative position here means that particular native will have the ability to take decisions, ability to take responsibility in life. Now what does the authority do? Authority have the power to make laws, if necessary, to change the laws, to take appropriate decisions. Now these are the things which can be well said by a government. That is the reason Sun represents a government, because government take actions, appropriate decisions, it makes laws, it cut down laws sometimes, if necessary, it makes new laws. Appropriate decisions are taken by government to run the nation, to run a particular sector. And the persons who are working for the government or working for the nation at the higher position can be seen through Sun, because Sun gives that particular position in the life of that native, because it is well dignified in the horoscope maybe. That is the reason that person has got that position in his life. If you talk about the zodiac, then Sun is the significator of the first house. That means in the first house, whenever a native takes birth, it is represented by the first house. That means the first house represents our body and our soul. And since Sun is the significator of our body and soul, it is also known as Atma Karaka. It is well dignified as a significator of the first house. And since it is the significator of our body and soul, it also defines the vitality, the energy of our body, means how much energetic we are, how much pressure can we take in our life, how much work we can do without being tired. That energy is given by Sun. How much powerful our soul is, what the soul is thinking, what is our impression on others, that is all done by Sun. Sun represents our ego, our pride, our self-esteem, the courage, the splendor, the valor, all is seen by sun. Whenever we talk about any famous personality, it may be a Bollywood star, it may be a cricket player, it may be a Hollywood icon. Once, just once we hear the name and we understand who the personality is. It's because of their name and fame. Now I'm standing here, the sun rays are falling on me. I cannot ignore the valor and that personality of sun. It is falling on me, I cannot ignore it because sun gives that name and fame. It is widespread just like the rays of the sun. Similarly, if we talk about any famous personality, their name and fame is so high that people move in and around them. Just for a single click of autograph or single click of a photograph, people will run behind them. The same thing happens with a king. People move in and around a king. That name, fame, status, mass fame, prosperity is given by sun. Now these all are the significations of the 10th house. That is the reason sun is also the significator of the 10th house. Government is signified by the 10th house and sun is the government. If we talk about our family, then who is the authority of our family? Father. Sun represents our father. And since sun represents our father, the teachings of our father, the relationship of our father with us and our relationship with our father is also represented by sun. That is the reason sun is also the significator of the 9th house of dharma. Because of this, all these effects, we can say that sun fulfills all the significations of the 1st house, 9th house and 10th house. If sun is well dignified in a horoscope of a native, then that particular native will get the blessings of sun in those sectors in a well dignified way. Now let us come back to zodiac again. If you talk about the 1st house, then when the sun rises in the east, just now like it is rising, it occupies the 1st house. And that is the reason 1st house represents the body and soul. And the soul and the body gains energy, that positive energy. It takes away the darkness. That means in the morning time when the sun rises, the sun is deposited in the 1st house of the zodiac. In the afternoon, sun will be in the mid-heaven, in the zenith. That time sun will be in the 10th house. Why? Because in the afternoon, the sun will be very powerful, bright. And that is the mass fame we get from the 10th house, because 10th house is the place of fame, name, status. Because sun is in the 10th house. And in the 10th house, sun gets complete directional strength. And in the 1st house, when the sun is rising in the morning, that is the reason in the natural zodiac, 1st house is represented by Aries, and in Aries, sun gets exalted because sun is rising and sun gets exalted. In the 10th house, sun is very bright, sun gives name and fame. That is the reason sun has got the complete directional strength because it is on the top of our head in the zenith, the complete directional strength. In the evening, when the sun sets, sun gets debilitated in the original 7th house of the zodiac, that is Libra. In the midnight, in the night sky, there is no sun. That is the reason at that moment, sun loses its complete directional strength because that time it is in the 4th house. 4th house represents the night sky, the midnight sky, and it is opposite to the 10th house. If this is 4th house, then this is 10th house. So this is the position of the sun when it goes through the zodiac. That is the reason the placement of the sun in different houses will determine how the soul will think, how the soul will react towards the world, and how the world will have an impression on us. Now, sun represents the authority. Now, authority and the employees, the authority, the boss, the government, they have a high status, a high position. They are completely separate. The normal employee just cannot confront a boss, because boss has the power to remove him. Boss has set some certain rules and discipline, and that particular rule and discipline has to be maintained by the employees. It is very difficult for a employee to face the boss. Similarly, if I look at sun constantly, then I will have a effect. I cannot confront the sun. That is the reason sun is a separated planet. It is also called as a separated planet, because it is very difficult to confront the authority, the government, the higher positions, the boss. And in order to function, the authority has to take some strong decisions. Now, that decisions can be felt as if that it is being very rude or something like that, but it is not like that. In order to function, the authority has to take some strong decisions. And that is the reason, since authority and government is represented by sun, sun is also known as a cruel planet, because sun is impartial. This rays of sun is imparted all over the universe, all over the solar system. Sun is impartial. So whenever the authority takes a decision in order to make some good for the society, good for the government, good for the nation, good for the sector, then it has to take some strong decisions for the future of the nation, future of the sector, future of the department, future of the employees. That is the reason authority can also be very cruel at times. That is the reason sun is also known as cruel planet. It is sattvic planet, that is a different thing. It has got many good qualities. It is very sattvic in nature. But it is very impartial. That is the reason it is very cruel in nature. If we talk about the significations of the sun, then it would be day to night. There are many, many significations of the planet sun, the Surya Graha. But I will end this video by adding one more point, that in our day-to-day life, we get energy and light from sun, means the existence of this planet Earth, life, plant, animals, birds, is all due to sun, the energy of sun. The cereals, the grains, wheat, rice would have been not be there if the energy of the sun rays was not there. That means sun is responsible for the sustenance of this universe, sustenance of the planet, sustenance of the life in this planet. And that is the reason we respect the Surya Graha as Surya Narayan. We respect him, and by respecting him, all we call him as Surya Narayan. And by this, I will end this video. That's it from my side. So next time when I come back, I will be bringing the next planet, that is Moon, the Chandra Graha, and its signification in Vedic Astrology. So I hope you have liked the video, and if you have really liked the video, then put the thumbs up, hit the like button, and if you have not subscribed the channel, then subscribe it for getting the regular updates. Hit the notification bell icon so that every time I make a new video, you get notified instantly. So I am signing off for today. Bye bye. Happy Sunday.